this ceasefire is being termed shaky at best. Why should we believe this one will hold when so many others have failed?
Well, it's not going to hold, and it's a temporary placeholder at best, because as long as the warring parties in Syria, namely the Syrian government and the Syrian armed groups, don't come to a ceasefire agreement, a final peace agreement, then the fighting will resume.
And also, Idlib is really, as I understand it, the last real stronghold for the armed opposition. And we've seen a staggering amount of violence, and just the pictures of the women and children pouring out of that area. Tell us about the human tragedy that is unfolding.
It's a human tragedy because the Syrian and Russian governments have been relentlessly bombarding Idlib, which is indeed not just the last holdout, but the concentration of all of the armed groups and fighting groups that have survived, that have been pushed out of the rest of the country. So rather than put their arms down, the armed groups have concentrated as a refuge in Idlib, and that is why the government is now pulling all the stops to finally end the war with defeat for the armed groups in Idlib. The intensity of the bombardment is what has led to this massive displacement of Syrian civilians, hundreds of thousands of whom are now amassed at the Turkish border.
And with that in mind, and for those refugees too, almost many of them are women and children. But really, Turkey and Russia have different goals in this as it's moving forward right now. Can you explain that and how you think that all the sides can make a way forward?
Well, the only way forward is for a final peace agreement wherein all the parties put their arms down. That means the armed groups in Syria and the Syrian government. Short of that, the fighting will continue and civilians will continue to be dramatically the highest cost payers in this conflict. The Turkish government's primary interest now is in preventing hundreds of thousands of Syrians from entering into Turkey. It's got 3 million Syrian refugees in the country already, and politically it really can't sustain anymore. There were a number of recent electoral losses for Erdogan's party that at least many have blamed in part on the presence of so many Syrian refugees. And from the Russian government's perspective, of course, they just want to defeat the armed groups in Syria and to declare themselves a victor.
Right. And Russia's had so much at stake for such a long time in Syria, and I read an article by you just before I came out, and it just really goes to show this has been going on so long, and there seems to be so little hope. I mean, I don't mean to sound so negative, but how can you give anybody in that region or anyone who has someone, a loved one in that region, any kind of hope?
I mean, I think the hope comes from a rather obvious answer that even elementary school children can understand at this point, which is there needs to be a peaceful, negotiated solution to this conflict. There will only be a tragic military solution, more tragic than the one we've already seen for the past 9 years in Syria, if the fighting continues. Obviously, the armed groups have not achieved their aims,
right.
and I think really now, for the remainder of the Syrian people, it's time for this war to end.
It is a grim story. Sarah Lee Whitson, thanks very much for coming on, adding some insight into this, and it's not going away, so I'm sure we'll have you back. Thank you again.
You.